I have a macOS MenuBar app that previously used an AppKit workaround to get the MenuBar item to work. In this video, I explain how I transform it to use the new MenuBarExtra in macOS Ventura, just using plain SwiftUI instead of AppKit. This video does not have a sponsor. If you like my work or learn something from my videos, please consider subscribing. And if you're an indie developer working on your own projects, I suggest checking out LaunchParty on the Mac App Store. It's a free project management tool that I developed myself. So looking at the app here, it's a very simple menu bar app that displays a piece of text basically that the user can set inside of the app. So it's basically like a daily focus app. It's called Dojo. The user can set a string like do stuff today and then it will be shown in their menu bar. So this works using the app storage property wrapper. So just saves the string to user defaults, and then the menu bar item just reads that user default string and displays it in the menu bar. So previously I had to use an NS application delegate adapter, which is basically an app delegate that you can add to your SwiftUI apps, because that was just needed to create the menu bar item. Now with the latest iteration of SwiftUI and macOS Ventura, there is a new type of scene that you can use, and it's called MenuBarExtra. So you can just use that in your app struct, and it has a few different overloads. The one I'm using here has one closure for the view that is displayed when the user clicks on the MenuBarExtra, and then one closure for the label. So in this case, I started out with an actual SwiftUI label, but I then thought that I should probably just have a text of the current focus, which is that string from user defaults. And if that string is empty, I will just say no focus set, so the user still has something to click on in their menu bar. It's also important to note that there are two different menu bar extra styles. There's .window, which is the one I'm using right here. Very nice if you just want to customize your SwiftUI view to look however you want it to. And then there is .menu. Now in this case, this looks awful, but that's great for just plain old NS menu or context menu, it's called in SwiftUI apps, that are just basically a list of buttons and text. So in this case, we're just using the .window style. And now the most satisfying part, I deleted the entire folder containing our status bar controller and our app delegate. If you're interested in how this previous approach with a status bar controller and an app delegate used to work, then you can have a look at the video link down in the description where I actually implemented a menu bar app for macOS Monterey a few months ago. And there I used this AppKit workaround that I'm now removing from this app right here. So after getting the menu bar item to work, or the menu bar extra to work, I'm starting to, you know, tweak the design a little bit. Obviously that ninja image was way too big previously, and I could have fixed that beforehand as well, but now I'm taking the time to actually improve the design a bit. Something also very interesting to note is that window sizing on macOS behaves very different compared to iOS, and usually the user can drag to resize an image a window on macOS, but with the menu bar extra, it actually calculates its own size and you don't even need to add a frame modifier. So right here, it's pretty big because I'm still using a scroll view, and I think I'm getting rid of that in just a second. But as you can see, I'm not having any frame modifier in my container views anywhere, just of course on the image to keep it rather small. Then I'm also removing that form at the bottom there and just replacing it with the text in the text field. And I think this square border text field style is actually also new on Ventura. I'm not entirely sure, but I think it looks very nice inside of a menu bar extra. Not too much of a fan of it in regular macOS apps. So now getting rid of that form, it already looks a lot nicer in my opinion. And I think this is the time where I actually also get rid of the scroll view. Okay, and now you can see that the window is only the size that it actually needs to be. So this is all done automatically by the SwiftUI framework and some of the underlying AppKit APIs probably. And this is already very close to the final product. Now I think I'm also getting rid of that sound toggle here in just a second, or playing around with the quit button as well. Yeah, right, it's also very important. You notice in our Dojo app abstract, there is no window group. So there is no actual application window that the user can open. And thus, there is also no way to quit the app right now without using, without actually killing it through macOS. So when you have a MenuBarExtra only app like this, you probably need to add a quit button to it or another mechanism to quit the app. Okay, so here I'm just playing around with the layout a bit, pushing that quit button to the side, and I'm trying to get it to be red, but I think that the MenuBarExtra doesn't really like that, or maybe I just didn't do it correctly, so the tint modifier didn't work, the foreground color modifier I think also didn't work. And then I think the roll argument for the button also didn't work, which usually does the trick if the tint and foreground modifier don't work. But for some reason, I just couldn't get a colored button inside of a menu bar extra. I'm not sure what the issue here is, but nevertheless, I mean, this works as well. And as you can see, pressing the quit button does actually quit the app. So that's a very easy call. Just say NS application.share.terminate. Super easy stuff here. So now I believe I'm thinking about removing that sound feature. Yeah, that was never really a great feature to begin with. So I'm removing that toggle, and I'm also removing that app storage property wrapper. And then of course the sound file that I was previously playing. I used the subsonic package by Paul Hudson, I believe, for that. And now, of course, I can also get rid of the subsonic package because, yeah, I'm not playing any sounds anymore. So that's a quicker build and a smaller app binary. So a win-win situation, I would say. All right, so that was my approach to rewrite a macOS MenuBar app from the old NS application adapter and MenuBar item stuff and so on to the new MenuBarExtra API in macOS Ventura through the new SwiftUI 4 iteration. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more videos, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye!